This is Mission Control Houston, Expedition 28 on board the International Space Station. A very busy day with science, with visiting vehicles, and with sharing the journey during this day on orbit. At 4:37 a.m. Tuesday morning, Houston time, the Progress Supply Ship 43P undocked from the International Space Station from the aft end of the station at the Zvezda module. It's packed full of trash being carried away for disposal when it is ultimately deorbited on September the 1st. But first, that Progress vehicle is going to be used for engineering tests commanded from the Mission Control Center in Korolev. It has been moved away from the International Space Station into what is known as a parking orbit for those other operations to continue between now and the deorbit burn at the 1st of September. There will be a new Progress Supplies ship launching to the International Space Station on Wednesday morning Houston time and should dock to the International Space Station this coming Friday morning. Today, flight engineers Sergei Volkov and Alexander Samokutyaev completed some refresher training on the TORU system, the remote docking system that would be commanded by the crew members themselves in case the automated docking had any difficulty. That training done to get them just brush up on their skills for the Friday Progress docking. Samokutyaev and Commander Andrei Barasenko also spent some time starting up to pack up the Soyuz spacecraft. And Flight Engineer Ron Guerin joined them with other departure preparations. Those three members of the station crew are to undock from the International Space Station on September the 7th for a landing in Kazakhstan on September the 8th. Barasenko and Flight Engineers Satoshi Furukawa and Mike Fossum also spent more time unpacking the other Progress vehicle that is already attached to the International Space Station. That was before Furukawa and Fossum moved on to data takes with the integrated cardiovascular experiment and the first use of a brand new ultrasound equipment on board the station. This experiment is designed to quantify cardiac atrophy that's associated with long-duration flight. It involves an in-flight cardio exam both before and after exercise, and the results of that will be compared with pre- and post-flight cardio exams for the crew members. Furukawa also had an opportunity for a VIP event with the Prime Minister of Japan today to talk about life on orbit and answer questions from students. The crew members will spend their time on Wednesday in a variety of experiments on board the space station, as well as additional Soyuz departure training in preparation for the arrival of a new ship of supplies due at the International Space Station on Friday morning.